and dancing just flex. Real flag boss now I just flex.
Just flex, tell them say pray your word.
Well, give me chance to play with some more. Roots and culture, you will come
for explore.
Just flex
TV, come for explore.
Okay, all right, I'll let you say. Hey, praise the Lord, people of God. Listen, do y'all remember the last time we was here in Jamaica, this gentleman gave me the word? Remember, he prophesied to me. He told me when I go back home about what God, you know, is going to do in my life. And the thing about it, he don't even know this. A homeless gentleman here on the street, so we bless him or whatever. He told us he needed some things. So the thing about it, he prophesied to me when I last time we were here in Jamaica. He told me how the God is about to bless me and about the doors, what God is about to do. I haven't told him yet, but he don't even know it. The president is about, they giving me an award for a lifetime achievement award. Yeah, they're back home. Look, so back home, they're giving me their Lifetime Achievement Award because I didn't even know people been watching me, but they've been watching us as our ministry been going out feeding the homeless and how we've been on the streets helping people in need, taking people off the street. We've been doing a lot. Yeah, and you didn't even know it, but before I left Jamaica, you prophesied to me. And you told me that the Lord is about to bless you. He's taking you higher. You went to saying all kind of stuff to me, and everything you said came to pass. Some of the stuff you said, I'm not going to say on camera that happened, but everything you said came to pass, because sometimes you got to use wisdom. Because when you tell people too much, you know the enemy don't like to see God blessing you. But look, do y'all remember him? You can say hi to him now. Look, you can say hi. Oh, he crying. It's okay, Mr. Mike. Yeah, it's okay to cry. Yeah, it happened. Yes. So every word that you had gave to me last time I was here in Jamaica, how you prophesied. And listen, people of God, we're going to bless Mr. Mike with some groceries today, too. So,
Prophet, you're getting the information for me.
Before me and Prophet was going into the barbershop, we saw Mr. Mike here. And he was telling me, hey, Pastor, you know, stop me. I was like, what's going on? So he said, you know, he needs some things from the grocery store and stuff. So we're going to bless him with some groceries, y'all. But listen, it's okay to cry. It's okay, Mr. Mike. But last time I was here in Jamaica, just before I was getting ready to leave, Mr. Mike came up to the car. He was like, hey, you, sir. And he began to prophesy to me. And he was like telling me how the Lord sees what you're doing. He didn't even know that I go around feeding the homeless. He didn't know nothing about the ministry. He said, the Lord sees how you're helping so many people and all that. And just, you know, just so much stuff telling about how God sees my heart and how you're so giving and just being there for people and stuff and saying, God is about to bless you, man. And he went to telling me all these things that God is about to do in my life. And I'm telling y'all, people of God, every word that this gentleman spoke to me the last time that I was here has came to pass, and some of it's still coming into fruition. God is still fulfilling it, but like I said, I didn't even tell him yet until just now that they're giving me a presidential lifetime achievement award for all the stuff that they see me do. So they've been watching me, and that's why I tell people, you never know who's watching you. So that's why it's very important to be obedient and consistent to whatever God has called you to do. A lot of times people feed homeless because they're like, I could do this to get this or this. No, but when your heart is in it, God gonna reward you no matter what people say about you. If your heart is in doing something, do it with all your heart. The Bible say, work as if you're working unto the Lord. A lot of times people start a thing and they stop because really their heart ain't in it. They doing it for man's recognition. They want to be seen by people, and God ain't gonna bless it. But when your heart is genuine and you're serious about this, God gonna make sure you never lack. He gonna put you on the heart of people you least expect to do it. So oftentimes I get people inboxing me. They say, hey, Pastor Cornelius, how can we start feeding the homeless? Hey, Pastor Cornelius, how can I do this? And I say, listen, if God didn't call you to do this, don't you dare do this, because you don't know what type of demons you're going to encounter. There's times I've been praying for people and the demons manifested in a person and he began to growl at me like a dog. But listen, if God never called you to this, you wouldn't know what to do in those situations by casting out demons and stuff. So never try to mimic someone else's vision. If God called you to be a baker, to have a restaurant, be the best at what you do. If God called you to be a massage therapist, guess what? He allowed you that field because there's healing in your hands, because while you massaging those clients, you could be declaring healing over their body, binding up sickness, casting out demons as you're massaging them. So whatever you do, do it as if you're working unto the Lord. So this is why when people come to me about saying, how can I do this? How can I do that? Listen, if Holy Spirit never called you to it, he you wouldn't be asking me that. I mean, if the Holy Spirit tell you to do something, he's going to give you strategic instructions. For example, before we came here to Jamaica to feed the homeless, we was back home. And people is jealous because of what God was using us to do, how we go out there and buying clothes for the people. Some people, we putting them up at Airbnbs where they can have a place to stay. So yes, paying for them a room because they was getting government assistance. So we'll pay for the room for them and they'll just pay the monthly fee, whatever it is. So we pay that they have a place to stay. We get them off the street. We even bought a car for one lady and stuff, you know, so as Holy Spirit lead us back home. So the enemy saw how much we're doing back in my own state. So they sent one of the guys, he have a family member that works for the city. Now, mind you, I had just talked to the police officer. They said, it's okay, feed the homeless, because I asked, before I do anything, I always ask for the police permission in that community. I say, sir, hey, is it okay if we feed the homeless? You know, I'm a pastor. Our ministry, we go around the world, we feed the homeless. Mm-hmm. And the police said to me, sure, of course you can feed the homeless. I would never tell you not to. But then the next day, we fed the homeless that day. The next day, we came back out there to feed them. A gentleman pulls up. He's on his cell phone, right? And he's talking, and I could tell he's talking to somebody he know, because he kept putting his head down. He was like, do you have a permit for this? And saying, I say, a permit to feed the homeless? I say, sir, this is a ministry where Heaven's Impact, I'm the pastor. And he was like, but are you allowed to feed here? I say, sir, we just asked because he was trying to tell me that I shouldn't be feeding. I say, sir, I have it on video camera. Well, we asked the police officer yesterday, can I feed out here? And then he was like, then he got quiet because you could hear the person on speakerphone talking to him, because they was talking back and forth in their language. I believe he was speaking Creole. But it was going back and forth speaking his language. And I'm like, isn't it a shame? Somebody coming out here to help people, but then there's somebody trying to stop what God is doing. This could be your family member out here. This could be your auntie, your brother, your sister. So you basically want to say that you don't want people helping your family. They ain't got nobody else to help them. So anyhow, what happened, the man came out there. So the Lord revealed to me, Cornelius, just like in the Bible days where the Bible say a prophet is without honor in his hometown. So Jesus, he even left his town to go do miracles, heal and stuff. He says, so what the enemy meant for evil, I'm doing it for your good. So now that they kick you, you know, they're trying to stop you from serving in your own area. I want you to travel the world doing it. So now we come to Jamaica. Now we feed downtown, different parts. Now we going to the Las Vegas. We've been going to Texas. We went to South Carolina. So everywhere that there's homeless people, if we know, we'll have somebody investigate the area so we know it ain't somebody trying to send us on a blank mission. And then we go and we help the homeless in the community. So this is what I want to say to people. Sometimes in order for God to bless you, in order for God to take you to that place where he's called you to be, sometimes you have to leave the territory where you're familiar at. The Bible even tells you a prophet is without honor in his own town, which means sometimes your mama gonna reject you because they don't believe in your dream, your aunties, your brothers, your sisters, your cousins. Sometimes they gonna try to speak against what God told you to do. Now, you know the Lord told you to go out there to lay hands on the sick so that they shall recover. You know that God told you to do this, but here it is, your mom telling you, baby, I'm just fearful. Don't do that. You know it's crazy. People out here, let me tell you something. God will never call you to something and not cover you and protect you in it. Because there's been times that I was going somewhere to feed the homeless, and I'll go into a dream, Holy Spirit will give me a vision, and I'll see something in the spirit realm that say, don't go there. And so we'll go a totally whole different direction from where. There's been times where the Lord will just tell me, book a ticket the next day, Cornelius. I want you to fly to Jamaica and feed the homeless there. And that's how I'm here now. Because the Lord led me to come here and bless the homeless here. So this is what I want to say to you people. This is why it is imperative that we have the Holy Ghost. This is why it's imperative that we pray, that we hear from God. The Lord is always speaking. But guess what? When we got so many people with gossip and negativity in our ears, causing all kind of confusion, it's hard for us to hear from God when we got all kind of nonsense. That's why the Bible tells us, God, guard your eyes and your ears. Because if you're picking up the phone, people talking against other pastors because they're jealous of what this one ministry got. So now they want to say, this one ministry is fake. This one is a hypocrite. But listen, instead of you covering that leader in prayer, praying for them, asking God to keep them, you on the phone gossiping and don't even realize that your gossiping is hindering the doors from opening for you. You think God gonna elevate you and take you places when you speaking against his other men and women of God? The Bible says, touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm. Which means if you have nothing good to say about somebody, the best thing you can do is cover them in prayer. Lord, cover them. God, I don't know what they doing in private, God, but I ask that you draw their heart closer to you and increase their hunger and thirst for righteousness. Increase their hunger to seek your face. This is why when we don't spend time in prayer, we won't know how to pray. A lot of us, it's hard for us to pray because you don't talk to God like you should. Because prayer should be easy for us. Prayer is just simply communicating with God. All day we can talk to him. Throughout the day. You know, even with the driver that we have today. We was led to the driver because we didn't even know the woman was sitting inside of her car, the driver, worshiping God. So we got in another driver's vehicle. He was getting ready to give us a ride. This is why it's important to be led by Holy Spirit. Another guy, we got in his car. He was about to give us a ride. I had him turn all the way around because Prophet noticed the lady. Prophet said, I want to ride with her over there. But we had already gotten the guy's car. I said, sir, well, can you drive us back over there? And I still paid him. I still gave him money. And I said, sir, I said, are we going to ride with her? He said, no problem, ma'am. No problem, ma'am. See, look, her worship caused God to send us to come to her and get in her vehicle. So now the driver, and I want to say this to people. A lot of you are in difficult situations and you're wondering, God, how can this situation change? If you would just take time to love on God, to pray, to worship him, even when you don't feel like it, say, God, I give you glory. God, I give you honor. I may not feel the best in my body, but you're worthy of the praise, God. My mind may be in turmoil.
And then for Northside, Imeds, representing for Just Blex.
Just Blex, tell them some prayer works when the healings are trying for you. Was he a dire hurt? The most I alert if I them alone.
Yeah, man, just Bex, you don't know your success getting them upset, you know what I mean?